Hello people, this is SelfTurts and in this video we'll see how to hide files in Visual Studio Code Editor. So this is my Visual Studio Code Editor and I have opened a project here which is in Angular 4 and you can see this is the project. So I'll give you an example related to Angular 4 and it can be applied to any project or any language. So this is the Angular 4 project and my source files are located inside this source directory. Now inside the app folder, these are the different files that I have worked on. So basically when I'm doing a project in Angular 4, I'm really interested only in the TypeScript file, the CSS file and the HTML file. But if you'll go to my blogs folder, you can see there are so many files present there. There is JavaScript file, there is map file, then there would be some spec files present here. So I don't need all these files because I don't do coding on that. I am only interested on CSS file, HTML file and TypeScript file. But when I see these many files present here, then it becomes very difficult to find a particular file. So how should I remove these files and only those files in which I am interested should be present in this explorer bars. To remove unwanted files from Visual Studio Code File Explorer, we need to provide some settings. So you can go to the settings tab by clicking on here and going to the settings, or you can also go from file and then this preferences and then the settings. So we'll go to settings and it opens two windows for us. The first one is this default setting and the right one is for the user settings. So in the default settings, these are the settings which Visual Studio Code provides by default. So here you can see a file section is there and inside that you can see you need to configure the globe patterns for excluding files and folder. So we need to write some more lines here to exclude our files. Currently in the files exclude the git file, the svn file, the hg file, the cvs file and the ds store files are excluded, which means if your project contains these type of files with extension of these type of files, then that will not be shown here. So to override it or to write our own settings, we need to provide the setting in our user setting. So we'll do some settings here and these settings are like this. So we'll say we need to exclude some files. So we'll say files.exclude. So files.exclude comes here and then we'll delete the default one. So if we delete the default one, then we need to provide our new setting. The first setting that I need to provide is **.js.map. So if a file contains this extension, then please hide it. So I'll say true. So what does this **.star means? It means you need to recursively find this file extension, that is js.map file extension, in the subdirectories also. If I have not provided this ** in the as a prefix to it, then only in the current folder if there is a .js.map file is present, then it will hide that. But I need to file in the subdirectory also. So I'll say **.star/*.js/map. I'll save it and you can see here the files have gone. So now you can't see any .js.map file. So if I'll again delete it and I'll save it, you can see the js.map files are present here. But if I'll again write it here and I'll save this file, so it will hide those .js.map file. The second setting that I need to do is I want to remove the spec file. So I'll say **.spec.ts file. So all those TypeScript spec files should be removed. So I need to provide a comma here and you can see the spec file is also gone. Now all these JS file that are present here, I don't want to see them also because I don't work on JS file if I'm working on a TypeScript project. So what I'll do, I'll provide a new setting and this time I'll say **.star/* and then .js, all the JS file which is present in subdirectories also. But when to hide them? Here you need to provide a condition. Suppose you are working on a project which is purely in JavaScript. If your Visual Studio Code has a setting to remove this true, then what it will do, it will remove the files in a pure JavaScript project also. But I want to remove the files when they are present in Angular project which contains TypeScript file. So if there's a TypeScript file, I don't need to work on a JS file. So what I'll do, I'll say if remove all the JS file when. So I can provide a condition here that when the base name, so I'll say dollar and then base name dot ts exist. So I'll say what, when the same base name file is also present there with an extension of ts, that is TypeScript, then remove that JS file. So if there is no TypeScript file with the same base name, then please don't remove it. So you can see how easy it is to clean your Explorer. So now you can see there's no JS file also present. So if I delete the last line and if I'll save it, then you can see here, then block component.ts is present. So there's a block component JS is present, but I don't want to work here on block component.js. So suppose I'll create a simple file here, say test.js. So test.js is present here, but there is no component.js file for that. Means component TS file for that. So if I'll save this one, you can see this time that block component.js file is gone, but this test.js is present. So you need to have this thing in mind that when the base name with the same base name file also exists, then only remove this JS file from my Explorer. So this was all about how to remove unwanted files from your Visual Studio code. You can also refer to my GitHub site and you can copy my Visual Studio code settings, which is damn good. I'll go to my GitHub and I'm on GitHub with a user selfturts. So this is my selfturts is my name on GitHub. So here you can see Visual Studio code settings are present here. And here in the user settings section, you can find these are the different settings. So you can directly copy it from here and you can paste it in your user setting. So thank you for this video. If you like my channel, please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then please give a thumbs up.